Yeah, ajmahari here. Whoops. I'm going to do another comment response here. Does it matter? Not does it matter, sorry. Is there a good time to talk to somebody with BPD or somebody you suspect who has BPD who might not have been ever assessed, or even a person that might have been diagnosed but you're not sure if they were diagnosed, but you're picking up on these patterns and, you know, they may well have BPD or the or traits of, but is there ever a good time to talk to them? Many people would say they think there are good times to talk to them. I would say basically, again, it's an individual thing, really, isn't it, with people with BPD? But overridingly, the majority of people with BPD who've not had really any substantial therapy or treatment to this point and are sort of in that untreated category, there really isn't ever a good time to talk to them about that you think that they have BPD, or to talk to them about the things that you want to try to get, quote, closure, unquote, from that kind of conversation, or trying to talk to them about how you feel. I mean, people try to do this all the time in these relationships, but there never really is that good time. So this commenter who commented on the video I did, Borderline Relational Impossibility, for loved ones, obviously, says there is a good time. There's a good time you can talk to them about things that bother you. So is there a good time? What do you think? Please leave a comment below. Let me know. What was your experience? What are you going through right now? Have you ever found that there's really a good time to speak to the person with BPD in your life or who was in your life? Was there a good time to tell them and to expect them to hear, understand, have empathy for, consistent empathy for what's bothering you? And so this person says there is a good time to do that, they think. You can talk to them about things that are bothering you. And the commenter continues, it's when they need money or something that they want. Well, that doesn't really work out. These conversations to try to say what's bothering you, how you've been hurt, what you need, if the relationship is on off, if you are, you know, in contact trying to get your ex back type of thing, there is not really a good time. And they're not really going to hear you. If what they want is to come back, if what they want to recycle again to do the same things over, which they're not necessarily aware of, if what they want is to talk to you, if they're back into an approach phase, it's still not a good time to talk to them, because it's going to mean that they will get triggered to emotional dysregulation, which is not your fault or responsibility. They won't hear you, and then they will go from being in an approach mood or phase to an avoidant, argumentative, chaotic, however their patterns are, type of situation. So if there was a good time for a moment, the second you start the conversation, the good time is gone, so to speak. So this commenter thinks that it's a good time when they want something, then you can tell them what's going on and they'll listen. Well, they might sit there and wait for you to finish because they want something, but they're not really hearing you. And then the commenter says, then they are willing to talk to you at the time of they're needing something. No, they might sit there and put up with it, but, you know, are they really talking to you? Are they really hearing you? Are they really paying attention? Can you, quote, make, unquote, a borderline pay attention to you and what you need to say and how you feel because they want something? I don't know. What do you think? Like, I don't think so, but please share in the comments below. And then the commenter said, however, they're just saying what you want to hear so they can get what they want out of you. Well, yeah. So do you think they're really listening? Do you think they really care? Do you think that they're open with all the defenses about you trying to tell them how you've been hurt or what bothers you or various other things like that? But when it's not about them, they're going to get triggered to emotional dysregulation and the defenses are going to go up. So the commenter kind of contradicts themselves here, saying there's a good time to talk to them. It's when they want something, but then they're just going to be telling you what you want to hear because they want something. So that's not really a good time to talk to them, is it? And the commenter continues, once they get what they want, they act like the conversation never happened and get really annoyed. I'm changing a word there. Get really annoyed when they bring it up. Everything they agreed to change goes right back to their old ways and they get so angry if you bring it up. So if that's the case, and I hear the commenter on that, that is often the case, more often than not, with untreated people with BPD or not well enough yet treated. I'm sorry that sounds so vague. I can clarify that more when I work with clients in sessions, obviously based on, you know, learning more about any individual person with BPD and what's happening in relationship dynamics. But the point of this is, so this person starts off saying there is a good time to talk to the person with BPD in your life, but not really, because they're just going to tell you what you want to hear. And then after they get what they want, whatever that might have been, or just getting your attention and time in because they felt in a bit of an approach phase, which they're not consciously aware of that usually, that, you know, after all is said and done, the conversation is forgotten. And not really forgotten like they forget, but, you know, they put it out of their minds. And then if you bring it up again, everything that they might have promised you, I guess this commenter had one of those conversations where in the person with BPD wanted or needed something. And so they tend to tell you what you want to hear, just like in Hoovers, especially in Hoovers, but also during relationships, if they don't just walk away from the conversation or get really angry, and it just... You don't push them, but the reality of BPD pushes them from approach for even what they want. And when it's about them to talk to you and you try to change that into, whoa, this might be a good time to talk to them about something, how you feel, what they've done. Could they go to therapy? Do they realize what they have these problems? There really is never, quote, a good time, unquote, to do that. And as the commenter said, so if they agree to stuff in a conversation like that, they're just telling you what you want to hear. More breadcrumbing of a different variety. And not always consciously by people with BPD. And then, as the commenter said, well, you know, after they get what they want, or, you know, they'll get annoyed by these types of conversations because they get very defensive because they're not able to take personal responsibility or accountability. So they're not really listening to you. And then when they make the promises that they'll make because they want to get what they want to get, that's kind of classic manipulation, consciously or unconsciously, by people with BPD. Next thing you know, as the commenter said, then everything they agreed to change goes out the window and they're back to their old ways. Well, you know, people out there with people with BPD, so many of you having various different issues, maybe PTSD, CPTSD, and or codependency, I hope you can hear this, or if you haven't heard this before, or if you've heard it before, but you're still trying to have these conversations and you believe that there might be a good time to have a conversation with somebody with BPD, especially when they're not in any treatment or they don't know they have BPD or they don't acknowledge or, you know, believe that to be true, etc. They're still fighting all of that. There is no really good time to talk to them. And what happens is what this commenter described. But interesting that the comment starts off with this sort of codependent, flawed, thinking or something that, oh, there is a good time to talk to them. It's when they want something, or it's when they're hoovering you back. It's when they're sort of entering, maybe like I could call it a mini approach phase again. So if they haven't been talking to you, if there's been a lot of conflict, now they're coming back because they want something, they need something. And why would anybody think that at a moment like that, a time like that, or any other time for that matter with somebody with BPD, that they're actually going to be able to hear you, that they're actually going to be able to show you any empathy when they're just telling you what you want to hear? So the commenter kind of took us in a circle, but I think it's just a good reminder for people, or maybe people are newer to this, there is no good time to talk to somebody with BPD about what you're experiencing, what's happening for you, because they simply can't hear it. They will not acknowledge it. They will not take responsibility. And if it seems like they are in a conversation, then as this commenter points out, watch out. Because when the conversation is over and they've met a need or they've gotten something else from you that they need or want, some concession or something, whatever it might be, then yeah, the conversation will be put out of their minds and you try to say, oh, so they do something the same again, whatever you might have been talking about. And then you say, hey, remember when we talked about this like yesterday or last week or 2 weeks ago, whatever the case, and we've talked about this several times over the years, months, years, whatever. Remember when you said that you were gonna change or stop or not do this or realize? Of course it'll be out the window by then, because it's just sometimes people with BPD do this consciously, but a lot of people don't. They just get, because it's what it's replicating what they did with a parent in childhood, right? Just trying to get what they needed, just being involved enough, coming, you know, into a place of not being uber defended with a parent perhaps, or in their own codependency, enmeshing with a parent at a time in their childhood or teen years, or even in adulthood for people with BPD untreated, where they're seeking something from a parent, and then they'll promise the parent the world too, and then the next thing you know, when the conversation's over and they got what they needed for that moment in time, excuse me, I don't know what you're talking about if you try to bring that up later. So, and often, even aside from significant other relationships, often parents with an adult child with BPD, and often these people with BPD, they have kids of their own. So there are grandparents, right? Parents of people with adult child of BPD, and they have grandchildren. And often the people with BPD will kind of use the kids as pawns. And the next thing you know, it's like whenever there's an issue or a problem with the adult child with BPD, perhaps untreated or not well enough treated yet, then they'll say, well, you know, like if they don't get what they want, and they'll just be, you know, giving excuses and telling a parent what they might want to hear. But people with BPD who have kids and are not, you know, well enough treated or treated, they will often just say, well, you know, you say this, you say that, like you can't see the kids, or they'll just ghost and discard for a time until the next time they need or want something. So there really is no good time to try to have a conversation. And by the way, let me just say quickly, it is not ever recommended, but so many people do it. It's not ever recommended that you try to talk to somebody that you think has BPD, whether you're dating them, whether you're married to them, whether you're in a relationship with them, whether it's a favorite, you're their favorite person, whether it's an adult child, whether it's a parent with BPD. There's no good time to try to tell them that they have BPD. That is not something that people should do, because it's a very codependent kind of, you know, also has an element of trying to control something there, to change something. You can't change someone else. You can't push them into awareness, and especially not people with BPD. So it turns out, really, from this commenter, but I mean, this would be what I would be saying in general anyway, there isn't really ever a good time to talk to somebody about BPD, about how you've been affected, because they're not going to hear you, if they're, especially if they're untreated. And there is, quote, never, unquote, a good time to talk to them, nor should anybody ever talk to them about, you know, I think you might have BPD, or even if they've been diagnosed and now they're like all in denial, but you were told that at some point, then he said, well, don't you think that you should get in therapy because you have BPD, because this, or you might give me some. That's not a conversation that anybody should ever have with somebody with BPD. And so may I just say, there's never a good time to talk to people with BPD or who you suspect have BPD about anything to do with that or anything to do about how you're feeling. And that should be your first red flag to realize these are toxic relationships or situationships, whatever the relationship type. And what are you doing? Why are you still there doing that? And believing that there could be a good time to have the conversation that would somehow be mutual and reciprocal when that isn't reality. So let me know your experience in the comments. Let me know what you think. What are you experiencing? What have you experienced? And do you think, really, have you got an example of a really, quote, good time, unquote, that you bound to speak to a person with BPD and they really heard you if they're untreated? And did it pan out that whatever they promised or whatever they said, well, they were seeking what they wanted? Because unfortunately, it is really all about them in a different way for different reasons than how it's all about the narcissist for the narcissist. So what's been your experience? Because I would say definitely there's not a good time to initiate any kind of conversation, all of which would be important for you, with a person with BPD or who you suspect has BPD. And that's really one of the key core reasons why people with codependency are abandoning themselves in trying to have these conversations over and over and around because they really don't go anywhere. Even if for a time you think, oh, they heard me, and maybe something will change. The only thing that changes people with borderline personality disorder is years of therapy. And that is not something that they can begin after years of your relating or on and off situations. It's really something that they have to choose and want for themselves, but it doesn't save relationships.